Before filming this travel show, I asked my followers from Slovakia, what's the most unique, extreme and mind-blowing thing worth filming here? And they all said one thing. Lunix IX, Europe's biggest slum. I beg to differ. I made a documentary about this place 2 years ago, and I can without any doubt say that there is something even more shocking that will leave you with your mouth wide open. Let's leave Lunix IX and discover probably the biggest curiosity of my home country. Welcome to another episode of the Slovak vlog. This time a very controversial one, I'd say, because we're visiting the Roma slums, which are a very complex problem and a topic of fierce discussions and also a cause of a lot of racism here in Slovakia. And you know me, I never show only the positives of a country. Instead, I want to give you a full picture and show you things that may be shocking or even terrifying. And these slums are definitely one of them. Let's go.
Lunix IX, a Roma district in the city of Košice in eastern Slovakia, known for its garbage-ridden streets, high crime rate, and the occasional brave foreign visitor with a camera, has been making significant progress in recent years under the administration of the new elected mayor. His policies got the district out of debt, and it seems that Lunix IX is heading towards a brighter future. Most Roma slums in eastern Slovakia were not so lucky with their mayors. In the worst ones, you're crawling through human feces, dead rats, and empty bottles of toluene, a chemical young people in these slums often inhale to get high. Today, we're taking a look at a place so appalling, you wouldn't think it was part of the European Union.
2 years ago, I made a documentary about seven of the worst Roma slums here in Slovakia. And for this episode, I chose the one in the village of Svinia, purely because it surprised us the most, not only in a negative way, but also in a positive way. There's no need to be scared. 99% chance that nothing's gonna happen. 1% chance that I may be wrong.
To make sure the 1% chance will not materialize, we had to find Aladar, a guy who guided me and the documentarist through the slum 2 years ago.
Aladar je doma?
Hej.
Môžeme ísť spolu za Aladarom? Hej. Aladar je v osade?
Áno.
Aladar.
Áno.
So we need to find Aladar as soon as possible. A hľadáme Aladara. Je doma Aladar? Aladar je doma? Ideme za Aladarom.
Čau, čau. Ahoj Aladar, čau. Nazdar, ako sa máš?
The reception from the Roma people was warm. If they see you're smiling and communicating in a friendly way, they return you the same emotion. Some of them may even make a surprising lively proposal.
Ale lepšie to vyzerá, ako keď som tu bol pred dvoma rokmi.
No, však bola nová asfaltka, išla cesta doma, chodníky sú nové.
Áno, vidím, že sa to tu zlepšilo.
Áno, stop.
So Aladar promised us that we're gonna have a party, a huge party.
Dobrý deň, prajem, dobrý deň.
Keď mieš nakýšený telefón, alebo taký, alebo...
Máš všetko, vačko.
Máme.
Môže byť do ruky, bo znáš ho tu.
No jasné.
To sebe dá, Vinko.
Jo.
Ale pohody sebe dá.
Ľudo, jeden, Ľudo. Ľudo, poď.
Hoj, je narodzený.
Ľudo, daj si.
Dneska narodky.
Ja odmietnem fakt, lebo nepijem alkohol.
Tak na zdravíčko.
No.
Na zdravíčko.
Na zdravie.
Cheers!
Na zdravie, cheers!
Ja ručnúšky zapíjem. To je sila.
Čo sa tu zmenilo za tie 2 roky, odkedy sme tu boli? Na zdravie.
Na zdravie. Poviem, všetko sa tu zmenilo. Vidíš, tie chodníky tam.
Chodníky spravili.
Poviem, každým tam. Školu teraz vybudovali.
Otec, to ma mrzí, úprimne sústrasť.
Otec mi zomrel.
Úprimne sústrasť.
30 mi umreli.
Úprimne sústrasť. Keď sme tu boli, tak tu bol trošku taký problém s tým, že niektoré deti užívali toluen.
Áno.
Ešte stále je to tak?
No už trochu, no takých 60-70% už. Koniec, bo včera aj dnes, keď šli do detského domova už. Viac než 50 ľudí. No sú to ešte takých tak 40-50 ľudí, čo fetuje ešte.
Fetuje stále aj malé deti?
No.
A to keď to dieťa si dá toluen a rodič mu nepovie potom nič?
Ešte bijú, ale už nie pomoci, chápeš, raz to zdajú si a už ich poláka.
Toluene abuse is destroying the slum from within, with young children trading cigarettes for doses of this easily accessible chemical. Instead of falling into despair and cope with their mounting difficulties, the Roma choose a lively approach to life.
I'm sweating like a pig. We're gonna drink some water. I'm completely wet. Best party ever.
As you can see, this is a completely different experience from what you'd expect. Everyone extremely friendly, they gave us water, they even gave us wine. We danced, they're really excited to play football with us. Right now, we're going to a hut or a house with no electricity. One of the houses in a very bad condition here with Aladar. We're gonna see the negative aspect of these slums.
So we had to give Aladar some cigarettes because these people always require something for the permission to film them. So we're going to bribe them with cigarettes.
Dobrý deň. Dobrý deň, prajem.
Vám pretekajú.
Čiže
keď
padá,
keď prší, tak preteká.
Všetko tu je ide.
Zomrem sama.
Nie, aj tak to mám mrzí úprimnú sústrasť. Úprimnú sústrasť, prajem. Takže tu sama bývate teraz? Sama. A toto funguje, táto elektrina?
Nie, to je tak nač. To nefunguje nič.
Áno. Toto asi nefunguje, predpokladám.
To je špalec. Takisto topí na drevo, no ale nemá ani drevku, bo to chudoba, znaš. To vidíš taký lavor, tam vodu zolé a tá sperie asi dá. No.
Tam v tom lavore sa perie.
Tam sa perie. A tu sa suší?
To tak, bo vonku nie, to nebo.
Ďakujeme veľmi pekne. Dovidenia.
No electricity and the lack of wood for heating and cooking are just some of the problems the inhabitants regularly face. As challenging as this may be, there are some members of the community that struggle with even bigger issues.
One of the most shocking things here is the presence of huge rats that are biting these people during their sleep. They're biting the children. That's absolutely terrible. There are more than 10 people living in most of these small huts. The capacity, I'd say, is probably for 2 people, and there are families of 12-14 members squeezing themselves in their small beds, being bitten by rats. It's terrible.
1, 3,
Môžeme prísť dovnútra?
To nič nemá vidno. Ešte 9 detí mám. Tu veľa také veľké patkanie mám.
9 detí býva s vami?
Manžel a 9 detí tu bývate. Mhm. Takže 11 ľudí tu. To sa tam dokážete vyspať 11?
A tu chlapci a tu dievčatá. To veľké patkanie a veľké bušici mám.
A ako sem prídu zo strechy tie patkanie?
Do strechy kukáce, akú mám.
A to sa cez toto prepchá potkan?
To veľké patkanie mám.
A to aké veľké prichádzajú?
To také.
Také velikánske. A potkan vyjde aj na
posteľ? Aj na postelici. To veľké patkanie a veľo pušici mám.
A elektrínu tu máte?
No.
Nemáte tu elektrínu.
Toto švičku budú mať.
Koľko máte rokov?
Ja 33.
33. A máte 9 detí?
Hej.
OK.
As strange as it may sound, progress is being made in this slum. These improvements manifest themselves in the form of a newly built drinking water well, concrete pavement, and a school. With most drug-addicted kids taken by child protective services, the slum is taking baby steps towards a better tomorrow. However, the main challenge still remains present in the most desolated areas.
Môžeme tu chvíľku ostať, lebo toto je najväčší problém asi.
Čo tam je?
Koľko máš rokov?
50 rokov.
Koľko máš rokov?
17.
A máš to len teraz pri sebe? Máš? A vieš, že to je zlé pre teba?
No, šest.
Nevieš? Odkiaľ to máš?
No.
No dobre, nebudeme ho tu.
The biggest problem of these Roma slums is what you've just seen. Toluene abuse and these people. And yeah, the... Čo sa deje? The problem is toluene is very accessible because you can buy it in a drugstore because it's a pain thinner. It's not usually used as a drug. It's used for household chores and stuff like that. So the adults, they buy the toluene in a drugstore. They usually sell it to these children who are dipping a piece of cloth in the bottle of toluene and then they're inhaling it. It's a very, very dangerous drug that causes passing out, and if you're using it for a long time, it may cause brain damage and eventually death.
They just said they would beat you up, the guys behind us,
really,
in Roma, but in Roma language. But one of the kids translated to me, uh-huh, and she said like we should go because they want to beat us.
Oh, okay, I think we may be getting into some trouble. They're shouting at us.
Walking around the slum, you can't help but to notice another alarming issue the people are ignoring: hygiene.
Kam chodíte napríklad na potrebu? Veľkú potrebu a malú potrebu?
Do kriakov.
Do kriakov?
No.
Čiže von?
Von.
Takže tu nemáte nejaký záchod?
Nie.
Čiže všetko vonku?
Ujde mi všetky cigáni.
Look at that. That's human. That's human. Smells terribly. Near this stream of garbage. It's rotting in the sun.
Most of the slum inhabitants are unemployed, with few of them doing community service. Many of them claim to be actively looking for a job, but when you ask them how, their answer is perplexing.
A pracujete niekde, ak sa smiem spýtať?
Nie. Nie.
Robíte aktivačné práce?
Nie.
A hľadáte si prácu alebo nie?
A si hľadám.
Hľadáte?
Hľadám.
A ako si hľadáte prácu?
Nie.
Chodievate na úrad práce alebo nie?
Nechodím.
Nechodíte.
And to finish off this unique and incredible experience, we're gonna play some football.
Messi, ukáž. Messi, to je reálne tetovanie? Wow, a Alena je čo? Kto, tvoja priateľka? Alena. Aha, takže dve priateľky. He's smoking while performing tricks. Real talent.
Messi!
They also said they're usually playing when it's completely muddy, even if it's raining, and then they're just throwing themselves in the river. Yeah. Okay, let's play some football.
Ball just fell into human shape.
They're fucking good. They play like maniacs.
These guys,
oh, they play like maniacs. They're like fouling us all the time, kicking us. There are no rules, so let's call it a day. I probably have human shit on my head. Okay, I think we should leave. Hey, it was enough. Okay, let's leave.
Dobre, odchádzame. Ahojte, majte sa, ďakujem.
It's really hard to sum this up without making someone mad, because there are so many bad stories regarding the Roma people of Slovakia. Robberies, beatings, exploiting the social system. It's a topic with so many questions and almost no answers. And I'm not here to provide the answers. I just wanted to show you another curiosity of my country and maybe make you think a little bit more about this issue, to think about it from a different angle. Laughter, wine, parties, football on the one hand, garbage, diseases, rats, and drugs on the other. Make up your own mind. Thanks for watching this episode. Hit the like button if you liked it, and see you next time.